Benz, a global corporation, was moving a senior executive into the area who's one of nine in North America. His responsibilities are the Cleveland Truck Plant, Thomas Bus in High Point, the plant in Fort Bill, and the plant in Mount Holly. They've been living for the past 6 years, 3 years in Mexico, 3 years in South Africa. Their kids are trilingual. The mother, as you might imagine, was very concerned about schools. And we had about 6 months to research and work with her to find the right place for her and for those children. And I can tell you, this was a mother that did research like none I've ever worked with. And in the end, what they chose was to live in Iredell County and place their children. They're both now at Mount Morin in the IB program. They found that to be the most challenging, the most effective program for the high-performing children. And I think, you know, while we talk about high-performing kids and wanting to keep them in our school systems and not in private and not in charter schools to enhance the performance of ISS, we also, with Career Tech, VPAC, Early College, provide opportunities for people to and families to save a lot of money in preparing their children for the world out there today and the technical and other jobs that are out there. And again, I'm just here to say thanks. You're helping me do my job better. You're helping all of us in this county in the value of our homes. And I wish you a Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Thank you. Next speaker is Anna James.
Hello. My name is Anna James. I graduated from North Iredell High School in 2014. I'm currently a sophomore at the University of North Carolina at Greensboro, a sustainable tourism and hospitality major. Look at me talking to people, that's my job. But I wanted to discuss the senior project. When I was a senior and we were going through the process of senior projects, at the time it seemed very draining and stressful and just, even at the time, unnecessary. But now that I am a sophomore and I've had time to completely reflect on the experience that I got from my service hours and my paper writing and all that you had to do for the senior project, I hope that that is a project that never goes away. I learned so much on how to turn in assignments and how to correctly address somebody that you would potentially work for someday. And I don't think that a lot of high schoolers see it that way right now. They just find it to be inconvenient or a burden on, or just another thing they have to do to graduate. But I can guarantee you that that was one of the most beneficial projects I've ever done, because now my easiest assignment that I had to turn in was at the level of that senior project that had stressed me out so much my senior year. And you can only move forward and grow from there. So I want to thank you for making sure that we had the materials and helping keep our teachers sane while we all tried to turn in our senior projects. It was very beneficial, and unfortunately it took me 2 years to realize that, but I quite enjoyed getting to learn from it. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Those are the speakers who signed up initially for the meeting to speak. I'll open the floor to anyone else who wishes to speak before the board. Do we have any others in the audience who'd like to speak before the board? Okay, thank you. I'll ask if there are any board members who have comments tonight. If not, we'll move into our superintendent comments. Mr. Johnson.
Thanks, Dr. Cash. I had a citizen contact me last week and brought something to my attention that I probably need to share with you guys and ask for a little bit of diligence and patience. It was brought to my attention that a lot of the videos that we make here on our regular board meeting nights had not been posted. And according to the gentleman that contacted me, he depends on watching those either on our website or on the local cable channel. So just as a friendly reminder, everybody, we are a guest in this facility. We do not manage the electronics and the communication. We do depend on the county staff to share this with us and to make that equipment available to us. We also have a very limited staff ourselves, and we have missed one recording. We had an episode of a board meeting back in the fall of the year where we got the video but no audio, and I can't explain why we don't have audio, but you can watch the proceedings. There's just no voices to go with it. And then we also had an episode back in October, I believe it was, that was recorded. Everything was going beautifully for about 7 minutes, and then it went blank, and we have no explanation of that. I will say that I've been in contact with the county manager, Ron Smith, and he and his staff have been very cooperative and helpful in trying to help us work out the kinks and the bugs. And if you want a more detailed explanation of that, it'll have to be somebody other than me, because I don't know all the ins and outs of all this electronic equipment and whatnot. But thank you for being patient with us. Our goal is to post all of these meetings on our website, and to also give a copy, and the county furnishes us a disc, which we then share with the city of Statesville for them to post on the local cable channel. So it's a little old-fashioned and antiquated. It's not quite as slick and smooth as we'd like for it to be, but we are trying to do a good job of making sure that these meetings are aired so that the public can watch these. Now, the other parts of my comment tonight have to do with whether or not we got our stuff to show tonight. Have we pulled that off?
They took care of it.
Hey, look at there. I'm going to show you two things tonight. I had a staff member come by recently and said, gosh, I know you guys have had some conversations about choice options for the school system, and we are extremely proud of the choice options that we have in play here in our school system, and I want to be one of the folks that applauds this Board of Education for supporting choice options. We do live in a state now that is promoting choice options very aggressively, and we want to be on the cutting edge of not only maintaining the choice options that we have, but also making sure that we're listening to our customers and that we are providing programs that they are interested in the future. And I might say, too, that when it comes to choice options, I had a two-hour conversation last Friday morning with a parent in one of our elementary schools who made a vivid point of telling me that at that particular school, her son is challenged academically, and that we're not meeting his needs right now. So choice options also applies to every single classroom in this county. And you've heard us say before that really we are striving to customize the educational experience for every single child in our district, because no two children are alike, and children do learn differently. So when we talk about choice options, not only are we talking about programs for schools in general, but we're also talking about those individual classrooms and making sure that we are customizing instruction to the individual needs of children. So if we've got a video, I think this kind of sums up where we're at in North Carolina. There was a day when we had a monopoly in the education business. Those days are over now. And so we do have to be very sensitive to what our customers are telling us. So let's see if we can watch this video.
Excuse me? Do you have soy milk?
Soy sauce is in aisle three.
No, soy milk. My daughter is allergic to cow's milk, so we need soy milk.
No. We don't have any of that.
Oh, well, what about organic milk? Do you have that?
Organic? Isn't all milk organic in a way?
2%? Skim?
I don't know anything about percentages, but all the milk we have is right there.
That's it? You only have one type of milk?
What you see is what you get.
But I want what's best for each of my children.
Look, milk is milk. We got one kind. It was good for me. It's good enough for kids today.
Come on, guys.
We wouldn't shop at a store that didn't have choices. Why settle for one-size-fits-all education?
Thank you. We'll close out my portion of tonight's meeting with another video, and I don't know if you watched the Panthers game yesterday or not, but there was a young lady from Brawley Middle School. Her name is Maddie, and believe it or not, she's in the sixth grade. And so she sang the national anthem yesterday in front of 80,000 people and probably a TV audience of 10 or 20 million people. But I thought you would enjoy seeing this if you did not get an opportunity to see it live yesterday.
I did not get that, so it'll take me a minute to get that up here.
Okay.
Try to find it.
Yep.
Is there going to be a series of those choice commercials that they're doing?
That comes from the Foundation for Excellence in Education, and I think you will see more of that in the future. They are promoting that as well so that public schools will continue to be competitive with the rapidly growing charter school movement in North Carolina. As you guys know, we do have four charter schools in Iredell County now. We have three more that are coming. We have 14 private schools and 2,000 homeschools. We have 6,000 students that live in Iredell County that have opted out of the Iredell-Statesville schools and are attending other choice options. So that's why we're very serious about this, and we want to make sure that all of our communities are addressed and that we're being fair and equitable as we go out to communities and offer these choices. And as I told you last week in your committee meeting, we're not mandating or cramming things down our principals' throats. We're asking our principals to engage their community and their staff members and be sensitive to the needs in your community and what are the ideas that your parents are asking for. And as those ideas bubble up from grassroots, then we will bring them to you and share those with you. This young lady that we're getting ready to watch is a sixth grader at Brawley Middle School. I would say we're going to be hearing big things from this young lady in the years ahead. She's very talented.
Another note, while you're getting ready to start that, we have a child, Sydney Stevenson. She was at Scott's, but I believe she's at Northview IB right now. And she sang back this summer, she sang the national anthem at the Hickory Crawdads game up in Hickory. So it wasn't quite as many as this one, but we do have a lot of talented students in our system. So.
Help both of those young ladies, I think, that they're
singing. I'll have to get that for the next meeting. This is not on the internet, and I don't have it pulled down right now.
I understand. So. And that's part of the glitches with us barring somebody's system. But everybody go home and watch that. It's posted on the Brawley Middle School homepage, and it is a stellar performance of a very tough tune, the national anthem. So congratulations to Maddie, and thank her for representing our district so well yesterday. Thank you, Dr. Cash.
Thank you. But we will need to go into closed session in a moment to discuss personnel issues a little farther, but beforehand, I'll make announcements of upcoming dates that you can follow with me on the screen. December 21st will be a teacher work day. December 22nd, an annual leave day. December 23rd through 25th will be holidays for our staff and teachers. December 28th through December 31st will be annual leave. January 1st will be a holiday. Then January 4th will be our next Committee of the Whole meeting at the ADR Education Center at 6 p.m. And January 11th will be our next Board of Education meeting here at the Iredell County Government Center at 6 p.m. I'd like to take this opportunity again to thank everyone for your attendance tonight and for being patient with us as we conduct a business for the schools.
Martin, you want to tell them about Thursday? Thursday, he said you want to tell them about Thursday.
Yeah, we tell them.
All the board's invited to the, I think everybody got a
Christmas
invitation.
Dollar Tech, in case you forgot.
That's the annual business lunch.
Okay. Well, at this point, I'll entertain a motion that we go back into closed session to discuss personnel issues. Any other items of business, Brady?
Motion.
According to the North Carolina General Statute 143-318.11, I make a motion that the board enter into closed session to discuss personnel issues and to preserve the attorney-client privilege. Have a motion and a second. All those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.